This presentation covers alternating current, or AC, generators. Moving an electric wire between the poles of two magnets causes electrons to move in the wire. Circular motion causes an alternating current. Here we have a little diagram that shows a mechanical input, a rather primitive one, and then we have a rotating loop in the magnetic field between the north and south pole of this magnet, and we get electricity enough to light a light bulb. The whole concept was conceived by Michael Faraday, who lived from 1791 to 1867. He was an English scientist who contributed to the fields of electromagnetism and electrochemistry. His main discoveries include those of electric magnetic induction, diamagnetism, and electrolysis. We'll be concentrating on electromagnetic induction. You can read the rest of this. He's quite a famous scientist, and we're still benefiting from what he accomplished. This is Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction. Generally, you can look this slide over, all of this results in, as you might have guessed, an equation where the voltage generated by a coil rotating in a magnetic field is equal to the number of turns in the coil times the rate of change of the magnetic flux per unit time. Here B is the magnetic field intensity, A is the cross-sectional area of the coil, and T is time in minutes or seconds usually. If a machine is constructed to rotate a magnetic field with the turning of a shaft, AC voltage will be produced across the wire coils as that shaft is rotated in accordance with this law. This is the basic operating principle of an AC generator, also known as an alternator. If you've completed the presentations and assignments on trigonometry in this module, you might have guessed that an alternating current AC waveform is sinusoidal. If so, you guessed right. The rate of change of magnetic flux through the coils is sinusoidal because the rotation of the armature of the generator is circular. The knowledge of calculus is helpful in completely understanding this, but the relationship between circular motion and sinusoidal waveforms at the heart of the matter. Think of it this way. The flux through the coil as the coil is spun is proportional to the angle between the face of the coil and the direction of the magnetic field. The current produced by the motion of the coil is proportional to the cosine of this angle. The current is therefore the same frequency as that of the circular motion and varies from a positive direction to a negative direction with time. Electric motors are generators run in reverse. A current in the coil of a generator causes the coil to move in the presence of a magnetic field. The generator now converts electrical energy to motion energy and is now called a motor.